Throughout the history of mankind, we have seen people who exert great influence and persuasion over others for personal gain and pleasure. Amazingly, there are certain methods and techniques that are used repeatedly to influence others simply because these methods are very effective. In this video, we will examine the seven ways you got played into making the wrong choice. Not only will you learn about the ways we are negatively influenced, you will also see how these methods are constantly being used in our society. Stay tuned. This is Mind Guilt. Number one, failure blindness. Suppose you are a pretty good writer. You come up with a great idea for a novel. You spend a few months writing your novel and your friends love it. You begin seeing yourself as a successful author. You start reading about the lives of great writers. Before long, you find yourself talking to an agent who can get you in front of publishers and can also get you self-published. All he needs is $3,000. The problem is you forgot one important thing. You did not even consider all the writers before you that failed. You only looked at successful writers. The fact is, you have very small odds of ever becoming a successful writer. The same can be said about artists, musicians, stock traders, entrepreneurs, photographers, Nobel Prize winners, and beauty queens, just to name a few. Failure blindness deceives people and at times can even ruin lives. Number two, a shift of perspective. You want to improve your physical condition and begin checking out some gyms. You visit a certain gym where everyone you see is in great shape with fabulous physiques. They have superior equipment and a nice atmosphere. You sign up because it's a no-brainer. After a few months there, you're really not pleased at the lack of improvement in your own physique. But as you've gotten to know many gym members there, you learn that many of them have spent their entire lives in gyms. It then dawns on you that they already had nice physiques before they even joined this gym. The gym just did a nice job of attracting people who are already in great shape. You saw their great physiques and you assumed the equipment was superior. Advertisers have used this trick for years as they get gorgeous models to sell cosmetics, clothes, cars, you name it. In fact, it is said that even top-notch universities do not really offer a better education. They simply attract the smartest students. Understanding this perspective shift can prevent you from being deceived in the future. Number three, pattern illusion. Have you ever watched the clouds and noticed recognizable shapes in them? Of course you have. It is only natural for the human mind to seek out patterns in the world around us. We have heard several bizarre stories in the news, such as where the Virgin Mary's face appeared in a slice of toast, or the face of Jesus was seen in a tortilla. The big problem with our mind's natural tendencies to seek patterns is we often think we see patterns when there are none. For instance, a gambler might bet on a coin flip to be heads after seeing eight straight tails being flipped. Yet, the next flip still only represents a 50% chance of getting a head. Market traders are forever looking for patterns in market data and charts, but end up losing all their money because of patterns they thought they saw. And during World War II, it was believed that the Germans were bombing London with rockets in a certain pattern, but as it turned out, it was only random. To keep from making damaging choices in the future, we must understand that pattern recognition is not something that we humans do very well. Number four, crowd deceit. You were offered a dinner and a free set of luggage to attend a free seminar about real estate investing. You enjoy the very nice dinner and then listen to 60 minutes of information about investing in properties. At the end, there's a sales pitch for an investing system that supposedly created lots of millionaires. Everyone pauses until one person steps forward to take the offer. Then another steps forward, followed by another and another. And before long, almost everyone is buying the program. What do you do? This is a prime example of what marketers call social proof. which is another name for peer pressure. Have you noticed how many types of advertising media out there use social proof? We see commercials and ads with lots of testimonials. The reason is that they're very effective. Social proof makes you feel comfortable about your decision to buy because there's safety in crowds, right? The only problem is that a foolish decision is a foolish decision, regardless of how many people decide to do it. Do not let the size of crowds deceive you or cloud your better judgment. Number 5, cut bait. You and your wife attend the opening of a very popular movie. You pay a premium price for the tickets and also pay dearly for the refreshments. After about an hour into the movie, you whisper to your wife, "This movie is awful. Let's get out of here." Your wife says, "No way. We spent way too much for these tickets." This is actually a problem that huge corporations deal with on a regular basis. They have projects with huge cost overruns, and executives will not drop the project because they've already sunk too much money into its development. This is known as the sunk cost fallacy, the reluctance to let go of items that have cost too much already. The cold hard fact is that a losing project is a losing project, regardless of whether you have already spent $50 on it or $50 million on it. We must understand when it is time to cut bait and leave. Don't make a bad decision worse by refusing to see it for what it really is. Number 6, beware of the freebies. You and your family are opening your gifts on Christmas morning as you have always done. After everyone has opened their gifts, your husband hands you a gift with your name on it that you've not seen before. He says it's from a lady down the street and he found it on the doorstep. What's the first thing that runs through your mind? It is probably something like, "Oh no, I didn't get her anything." Everyone would feel the same because of the law of reciprocity. We humans like to have things balanced in our life. If someone does something nice for us, then we feel we must do something nice for them. Advertisers have used this law on the public for many years. This is why we get free things in the mail. They want us to feel indebted. This is also why guys send drinks to girls in bars. They want the girl to feel obligated to talk to them later. Understand that when you accept a gift from someone, you must be able to deal with any obligations that might transpire from such an action. If you feel indebted, then you could feel pressured into doing something that you would not do otherwise. Number 7, beware of big voices. You show up early for an important meeting. Before the meeting, a few of you are talking about a concert that occurred over the weekend. The department head finally shows up, who is the highest ranking person in the room. He overhears the discussion about the concert and makes a comment that an earlier concert was much better. Several people in the room tend to agree with them, even though it's doubtful that they attended either concert. The fact is that because the department head was the most powerful person in the room, other people in the room assumed he was the authority in topics that were beyond his company position. Nothing could be further from the truth. It could be he knows nothing about concerts or anything else. We make a big mistake of assuming that people of authority are knowledgeable in many fields. We forget that they are constantly surrounded by people who want to please him so much that they rarely ever hear the truth. No one ever wants to tell people of authority any bad news, so unless they have a lot of wisdom, they rarely ever see the actual world around them. If you learned something new from my video, then subscribe to my channel right now. Let me know which of these 7 ways you got played into making the wrong choice you found most compelling and interesting. Leave a comment with your thoughts below.